given the function, we want to determine the function values. So to determine the value of f of 4, notice how the input x has been replaced with 4, which means we'll substitute 4 for x into the function rule here and here, and then evaluate. So for f of 4, we'd have 2 times 4 divided by 4 plus 2 plus 1. Simplifying this fraction, notice how we'd have an 8 in the numerator and 6 in the denominator plus 1. Well, this simplifies to 4/3. And then we can write 1 as 1 over 1. We know to add these, we have to have a common denominator, which would be 3. So we multiply this fraction by 3 over 3. And now that we have a common denominator of 3, we can add the numerators. This would be 4 plus 3, which is 7. So f of 4 is equal to 7/3, which means when the input into this function is positive 4, the output is 7/3. Graphically, this means that when the x-coordinate is positive 4, the y-coordinate would be 7/3, and this would be a point on the graph of the function. For f of negative 3, we'll now substitute negative 3 for x. So we'd have 2 times negative 3 divided by negative 3 plus 2 plus 1. Starting with the fraction, here we have negative 6 over, this would be negative 1 plus 1. Well, negative 6 divided by negative 1 is positive 6, so we have 6 plus 1, which equals 7. So here, f of negative 3 is equal to 7, meaning when the input is negative 3, the output of the function value is 7, which also tells us the function will contain the point with an x-coordinate of negative 3 and a y-coordinate of 7. Now we have f of 1/4, so we'll have 2 times 1/4 divided by 1/4 plus 2, plus 1. Well, 2 times 1/4 would be 2/4, or 1/2. So we have 1/2 here divided by 1/4 plus 2. Well, remember 2 is the same as 2 over 1. So we obtain a common denominator of 4. We'd have a denominator of 4. And the numerator would be 1 plus 8, which is 9. So we have 9/4 here plus 1. Now remember, a fraction bar means division. So to simplify this, we could think of this as 1/2 divided by 9/4, which is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal. So this is the same as times 4/9. So here the 2 and the 4 simplify. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 2 2's and 4. So this ends up being 2/9 plus 1, which we can write as 1 over 1. And now we obtain another common denominator of 9. Now that we have our common denominator of 9, we can combine the numerators. 2 plus 9 would be 11. So this one was a little bit more work, but f of 1/4 is equal to 11/9. Which means when the input is 1/4, the output is 11/9, or the function value is 11/9. And graphically, this means that when the x-coordinate is 1/4, the y-coordinate would be 11/9. So this would be a point on the graph of the function. And that'll do it for this example.